Alright, so let's open Gdevelop. Or is it open already? It's nothing new, it's the worm project we have been working on. So, here is the project of the worm. And you can see that now I can collect the apples. My score goes up by 10 every time I collect an apple. Now, if you don't have this project, download it from the forum. Or you can follow the previous videos. It's not that complicated, it's actually very easy to make. Alright, so that's what we're going to do today. Let's get started. If you don't have this project, download it from the description below. Let's open the example file, which you can find under the description below. I think I said that already. First, let's run this. And you can see that there is nothing in the level, except where you can scroll and jump. So the first thing we're going to need is an apple. Okay, so let's insert any object. It's going to be a sprite. Let's import the apple. Let's insert the apple. Where is the apple? Let's see. There's my apple there. So maybe we should rename this to apple. Let me edit this. There is our icon. Let's run this. There is our apple. But we can't collect it. Let me enable the grid here so we can place a few apples here. One over here, maybe two here, and another two here. Let's go to events and let's add a new event. This is going to be collisions. Collision between the worm and the apple. Okay, if that happens, we are going to destroy the apple. Now, where was that to? That was under objects. I'm going to delete an object. It's going to be the apple. And let's try it out. Let's see. Whoa, now we can collect the apples. Okay, that one maybe is a little too high there. I cannot collect that one. Make sure you leave something there so you can collect those apples. So now we need to create a score. Okay, let's do that now. Let's insert a new text object. If you don't have this enabled, just double click on it. Let's see. It's just gonna be called text. Cool. So right click on your level and let's modify initial variables. Okay, we already have one here. It's called player alive. That's from the previous tutorial. So let's add a new one. This one is gonna be called let's just call it score. Hit okay. Now if you run the game, you notice that nothing happens. Okay, so let's go to events. And under line 7, okay, no condition, we're going to display the variable on our text. So let's go to text, modify text, and the text we want to modify is the new one we just created, which is this one. So we want to display the variable there. Variables, scene variables, score. And we don't need these quotations. Let's hit the OK button. And yeah, let's run this. Let's run the scene. And you can see that now our text displays 0. The score scrolls with the rest of the background. Okay, we don't want that. Now to fix that, we are simply going to put the text in a different layer. So let's go to the layer editor. And let's add a new layer. Okay, maybe we can rename this. Let's call it, we call this one GUI, Graphic User Interface. You can call it whatever you want. And let's place this under our new layer, which is GUI. And that layer doesn't scroll, alright, so that's not going to scroll now. Let's collect the apples. And that seems to work fine. Whoa, I cannot still reach those apples. What's going on? So now we just need to add 10 to the score every time we collect an apple. Let's go to events. And when we collect the apple, let's go to variables. It's gonna be value variables, score variable, and it's gonna be plus one. I cannot see my keyboard. Whoa, it's so dark here. It's gonna be plus one. Oh, actually, plus 10. Did I mention I cannot see my keyboard? There we go, 10. And let's preview this. Collect the apples. And now we have a score. Whoa, that was super easy. Maybe we can add some enemies and all that fun stuff. Like the video. And I will see you in the next episode. Bye now.